Hey guys, Mr. Saving the Day, and we are doing a little squatching here. We're doing a little trip Blackwater. We're down by Pendleton Falls, but we happen to find this structure you can see behind me. Obviously not done by 10-year-old little boys. The placement of the sticks, as you can see, is quite intricate. Some of the ends seem to be driven into the ground 4 inches. We're going to keep our eyes open. We're definitely in some squatchy country right here. So we're down the Dobbins House Trail here behind Pendleton Falls. And we're just noticing how thick the vegetation is. Anything could be out here hiding. Anywhere. We've been hearing creepy noises every once in a while. And if you look ahead there, you can just see how the trail is engulfed in vegetation. Let's see. Everyone keep your eyes open, ears open. Make sure you look down low, because a lot of times squats will just lay low on the ground, believe it or not.
This point.
And down there below us is the Blackwater River. Cuts through this valley here.
Hi guys!
Mrs. Saving the Day is over there looking for possible footprints, that kind of stuff, biological material that could have been left behind. She's doing some DNA research.
Yeah.
So we're thinking of maybe doing a call here. Just seeing how it goes. What do you think? Should I? Looks like an awful good valley to do that. Well, after my call, we've heard what we thought may have been a response, so we're headed up through these pines toward the top of the hill. Everyone's keeping an eye out.
Is that a squatching monkey?
What the heck? That's random, right, guys? Wow. I'll be back when we got a little more info.
Right? Salamander?
It's a very common salamander up here.
You want to see it move?
Kind of neat.
Maybe it's dead.
No, he moved.
It's cold.
Yeah. It's not fast or slow, it's hot or cold.
Yeah. Our way out into an almost Jurassic field of grass here, alpine field. Show you. We're thinking maybe those noises could have been coming from here. Oh,
this
little butterfly.
Animal adventure.
Yeah, she is. We've worked our way into these pines, and you can see how well the dog is working. The dog has been trained by my son, and we actually trained her on following the scent of primate pheromones, just like someone might teach their dog to get pheasant or grouse. This dog has been trained to chase monkeys, pretty much, and she's been going on alert. Here she goes again. You could tell that there's something in the air that she's picking up. We're gonna work our way through these pines and down into this little valley and see where she takes
guys.
Us.
I am all of 6'5", and I can't even reach that tree break. That's pretty random, that high. Just you wouldn't expect something walking through. A deer definitely didn't do it. it would have to be as tall as a giraffe. I think we're on the right path, guys. Let's keep moving forward. Keep eyes behind us. Well, we are about done with our daylight research time that we could do today. We have been... Hey, you guys see, we're pushing this doe. She's running in front of us. You can tell by the tracks where she's running from something recently. We may have interrupted a hunt, you guys. I've seen this before. They try and block a route people use frequently, and they've pushed us off here to the side for some reason. Huh.